I don't know. I never imagined seeing you in a dump like that. Like Club Rio.
What's the matter with my baby?
You're already doing me, Mary. Don't know how to talk to you. Something's different.
What's different?
I don't know. Maybe if your nose was running.
Oh, right. Suppose it was.
Then I'd ask you to marry me. Oh, don't laugh at me, Mary. I've been feeling all night like somebody stepped on me. Inside.
Oh, I'm not laughing at you, Jerry. I was just laughing because I'm kind of happy.
I'm going to keep you happy. I'm going to get a job. Real pay.
Jerry, will you really try to work steady for a change?
Sure. Soon I'll be making enough so we can move away.
Yeah, we can save something each week.
You'll have the best of money combined. Swell apartment.
Maybe we could have the kind of, you know, they build on top of the roof.
Sure, if that's what you want.
And then maybe we could go to Europe on one of the big liners that come up the river. Why, thank you, Jim. You and me going to Europe together.
Oh, darling, if you'd only marry me, I could do it. The sky's the limit. I get you champagne by the bucket. We go to Venice and you'd be Queen of America. Maybe we can move out of the breeze. Well, Mary, what is it? Oh, you're crying. Oh, Mary, did I stick my foot in it again? What's the matter?
Oh, stop, Ruth. There's the Venice we'll get. 11th Avenue to Cherry Blossoms. No. Oh, sure, I'll marry you. You can both sit here in the summertime and watch our kids swimming in that soup.
Oh, Mary, don't cry. Yes, yes.
And what do you think you're doing?
Well, what does it look like?
One of them fresh guys, eh? You're on private property. And as for what you're doing, well, come on, get going.
I'm going home.
Mary.
Do you think a cop like that is going to snoot and wore our nose face?
And the said Jerry Glynn has from time to time been consorting with known criminals, gamblers, and former bootleggers. He has held odd jobs. He has inevitably been discharged for brawling and breach of the peace.
Jerry Flynn, this is a serious charge against you.
Yes, sir.
Solving an officer of the law?
Yes, sir.
Haven't you any respect for that uniform?
There's only a man in that uniform.
My boy, that uniform represents a thousand years of human effort towards civilization. Represents society's attempt to make the weak equal to the strong and the ruthless.
Why don't you jump in that crack right there?
Arms in this court.
Must you always be speaking out of turn, you bloody stud?
Jerry, the law says that I can sentence you to 3 years in the penitentiary. 3 years. Now, do you think your temper will cool off in that time?
Oh, Your Honor, may I speak to the lad?
What did you want to say?
I've been a scrub woman all my life, on my hands and knees, like a hammer. And bending over the wash tray like that, well, you know, the children were born dead. And then the poor husband's time came, I was ill. And then his father and Mary got some lettuce on his head. Brought Jerry to me, Your Honor. Jerry was so small, his ribbon was carried in his own pocket. And look at you now, so you, and big and handsome, and just, maybe a bit of dash in your own temper, and a blood on fire, and in love, as it should be. Your Honor, excuse me, don't touch it.
Go on.
Maybe you never think, Your Honor. You were so famous and rich. What the poor children to do in New York with their love? Where are they? Do they? If you take the path, or maybe the railway station just letting on to be saying goodbye to each other. That's all, Your Honor. Only maybe that's why Jerry smacked the car. Being young and hot-blooded and in love. He's all the children all in one, Your Honor. He's all I have to love in this world these days. And so maybe, Judge, maybe you just excuse him.
You may sit down. Jerry, what did you say?
Nothing.
What are you settling for? I thought you were so tough.
Who, me? I'm not settling.
Oh, won't you talk like
that? Well, how should she talk?
I don't know. Ball me out?
You can handle the people who ball you out, can't you?
Yes.
How about people who don't?
I guess I'm a heel.
Mrs. Flynn? Where do you work?
I'm in the newspaper business, Your Honor. As trap clerk for the New York Dove office.
Oh, pretty good business. Aren't there some street corners where Jerry could start in the newspaper business?
Oh, yes.
There's a legitimate job for you, Jerry. The tough. It's hard to make honesty pay. Harder than brawling or knocking down police. Next kid.
Say anything about that. that night, wouldn't it?
You shouldn't have
bought it. I'm going to buy you the earth and everything on it.
Oh, Mary,
for you. Well, the sky's the limit. Of course, I'm not thinking much now, but it's a start towards all the things we talked about.
You had jobs before.
Yeah, I know.